So very good evening children, welcome back to Akshar online classes, IIT and NEET foundation. Today we will discuss about that 8th class biology. Okay, I am Yuvat John sir, biology teacher. Today we will discuss about the microorganism friend and foe. Okay, shall we go to that discuss? So second lesson, first lesson crop improvement. Okay, second lesson is the microorganism friend and foe. Okay, first lesson is the crop production and management. Hello Avinash, very good evening Avinash. My voice is audible to you? So any doubt you can ask me. Okay, your voice is also audible to me. So today we will discuss about the microorganism friend and foe. Okay, please on the video. Namaste, very good evening. Welcome back to Akshar online classes, IIT and NEET foundation. Today our topic is microorganism friend and foe. What is that? Microorganism friend and foe. So actually in our surroundings we can see the living things. So what are the living things? What are the examples of the living things? Plants, animals, human being. Okay, so these are the plants and animals and human beings we can visible. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
So these are the organisms, living things we can see with the help of in your naked eye. Okay, some of the microorganism, which of the organism we cannot see in our unaided eye? Okay, naked eye. Such organisms are called microorganism. Which of the organism we cannot see with the help of that unaided eye? That organisms are called microorganism. Microorganism, how we can see?
Microscope.
So microorganism we can see with the help of the microscope. So these are the microscope was discovered by whom?
Robert Hooke.
No. Anthony van Leeuwenhoek. Compound microscope was discovered by the Anthony van Leeuwenhoek. Anthony van Leeuwenhoek. Okay, so here, so these are the microorganisms means, okay, here living organism around us which are normally cannot see, these are the organisms are called microorganisms or microbes. Okay, microbes are microorganisms. Microorganism we can see with the help of that microscope. Microscope was discovered by that Anthony van Leeuwenhoek. Anthony van Leeuwenhoek. So how many microorganisms are present?
Ask him to clear.
How many microorganisms are there? microorganisms. Okay, microorganism, we can see that with the help of the microscope. This microscope was discovered by the Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. Leeuwenhoek. Okay. So, some of the microorganisms we cannot see in your naked eye. Some of the microorganisms we can see with the help of the electron microscope. Electron microscope was discovered by whom? Null and Ruska. So which are the microorganism we can see the electron microscope? Electron microscope we can see with the help of the virus. Viruses. Okay. So here definition what? Microorganism, which of the organism we cannot see in our naked eye, unaided eye, we can see with the help of the microscope. Such type of the organisms are called microorganisms or microbes. Microorganisms are microbes we can see with the help of the microscope. How many microorganisms are present? Four types of the microorganisms are present. One is the types of the microorganism. So, classification of microorganisms. Okay, so actually microorganisms are classified into five types. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First one is the bacteria. Second one is the protozoa. Third one is the algae. Fourth one is the fungi. Fifth one is the viruses. Okay. So microorganisms are classified into five types: bacteria, protozoa, algae, fungi, and viruses. So viruses, these are the four microorganisms we can see with the help of the microscope. But viruses we can see with the help of the electron microscope. And viruses are the very minute organisms. Hello? Any problem, Avinash? Some of the disturbance is coming to you. Mute yourself. Now coming to the point, viruses is the link connector between the non-living things and living things. Viruses is the link connector of the non-living things and living things. So what is the meaning of that link connector between the non-living things and living things? So if the viruses are present in the non-living thing, that is the dead organism. If it is present in the viruses in the living organism, that too become a, okay, causing to the diseases. So that's why viruses is the link connector between the non-living things and living things. Here my question is, which of the microorganism is the link connector between the non-living things and living things? What is the answer? What is the answer, Avinash? What is the, which of the microorganism is the link connector between the non-living things and living things?
Yes, sir.
Which of the microorganism is the link connector between the non-living things and living things? What is the answer? Somebody saying virus, virus, virus.
Okay.
He are not listening.
He is listening.
But he are not saying the answer, but somebody saying answer. Actually, so that's why what I am saying, so please on the video said. Okay, no problem, no issue, but understanding is the very important. Okay. What is the link connector between the non-living things and living things?
Viruses.
Viruses. So, can we go to that? Here, microorganisms, some of the useful microorganisms, some of the harmful microorganisms are there. For example, bacteria, cholera, typhoid, diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, these are the, all the diseases are caused by the bacteria. And if you see the protozoa, in that protozoa also plasmodium is causing to that malaria. Next, you can see that fungi, most of the fungi, okay, bread mold, black mold, okay, agaricus. So these are the examples of that bacteria. Viruses, most of the viruses is the causing to the diseases to that polio, hepatitis, chicken pox, mumps, measles. This is the so harmful, viruses are the very harmful. Now we can discuss in that what is the useful of the microorganism and what is the harmful of the microorganism. Shall we go? Next our topic is, okay, where do microorganisms live? Where do microorganisms live? After ring the bell, after 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock, you ring the bell, where you will go? You will go to your home. Yes or no? So microorganisms, where they can live? Microorganisms, they can live in the soil. Microorganisms live in the water. Microorganisms live in the land. Microorganisms live in that, highest temperature and coldest temperature. What is the highest temperature? 100 degrees centigrade. What is the coldest temperature? 0 degrees centigrade. Some of the microorganisms, they can live to that highest temperature and lowest temperature. Final statement, microorganisms are live anywhere, everywhere. Are you understand? Microorganisms are present in the air. Microorganisms are present in the atmosphere. Microorganisms are present in the soil. Microorganisms present in the water. Microorganisms present in the land. Microorganisms present in the highest temperature. Microorganisms are present in the lowest temperature. So that's why microorganisms, they can live anywhere and everywhere. Anywhere and everywhere. Everywhere. Okay. Next. So, friendly microorganism. Now, another topic is you can see some of the diagram. Are you see that these are that? Are you see that bacteria? This is the Chlamydomonas, Spirogyra, Amoeba, Paramecium, Bread Mold, Fungi, Bread Mold, Penicillium, Aspergillus. So these are the some of the examples of the microorganism. Once you can see. Okay. Next. So this is the diagram for the viruses. This is the diagram for viruses. Next, here microorganism may be single-celled like bacteria, some of the algae and protozoa. So most of the bacteria is the unicellular organisms. And in that algae also Chlamydomonas is the unicellular. Chlamydomonas is the unicellular. In that fungi also yeast is the unicellular. Remaining all the organisms are the multicellular organism. Okay, they live in the all the types of the environment ranging from ice cold climate to the hot spring. That means they can live in the lowest temperature and they can live in the highest temperature also. Next, they are also found inside the bodies of the animals, including the humans. Okay, so some of the microorganisms grow on other organisms while others exist freely. So that means what you are understand? Microorganisms are present anywhere, everywhere. Are you clear? Next topic is microorganisms and us. Microorganisms play important role in our lives. Some of them are beneficial in many ways, whereas some other are the harmful and causes to the diseases. Now, so microorganisms, some of the microorganisms are the beneficial, some of the microorganisms causing to the diseases. So that's why now we can discuss about the friendly microorganism. What is that? Friendly microorganism. In the friendly microorganism, microorganisms are used for the various purposes. They are used in the preparation of the curd, bread, cake. Actually, preparation of the tea, preparation of the idli, preparation of the dosa, preparation of the cake, preparation of the curd, preparation of the bread, generally we can use it to the microorganisms. So microorganisms have been used for the production of alcohol since ages. Do you know beer, wine? Do you know alcohol? Alcohol, do you know? These are the alcohol we are getting from where? Microorganisms, nothing but fungi. Okay. Next, microorganisms also used in the cleaning of the environment. For example, if the plants and the animals dead, who are cleaning?
Not plants.
If the animals are died, okay, after certain age, everyone died, no? After that death, smell will come, no? There is no microorganism who are the cleaning the environment. So that's why microorganism is the, okay, microorganisms also known as the, actually they are the cleaning of the soil. Yes or no? Next, so the organic waste vegetable peels remains in the animal feces are also broken down into the harmless and useful to the substances by the bacteria. Okay, so these are the bacteria used in the preparation of the medicine in agriculture. They are used to increase the soil fertility by mixing up the nitrogen. Here what you are understand, microorganisms are useful so many ways, increasing the soil fertility, increasing of the medicine. Okay, so production of the medicine, preparation of the medicine, increase of the soil fertility, and they are the so many usages are present. Now making to the curd and bread. Do you know how the milk is, curd is prepared? Do you know?
With bacteria and
rice. How to preparation of the curd, do you know? First of all, your mother is taking to the bowl. In the bowl, we are taking to the milk. In the milk, okay. So we can add it to the some amount of the water. Then we can keep it to the stove. We can boil it. Half an hour we can boil. After we are cooling. Cooling after, we can add it to the buttermilk. After 3 to 5 hours, that milk is converted into the curd. This is the preparation of the curd. Yes or no? In this preparation of the curd, lactobacillus. What?
Lactobacillus.
This lactobacillus bacteria helped to the milk converted into the curd. Milk is converted into the curd. Okay. So which of the microorganism helped to the preparation of the curd? Lactobacillus, right? Lactobacillus bacteria milk is converted into the curd. Okay. Next. So, do you know fermentation?
Sir?
Do you know fermentation?
No.
Fermentation means? Your mother preparation of idli, do you know?
Yes, sir.
Your mother preparation of dosa, do you know? How she is making to the idli and dosa, can you explain? If you don't know, ask to your mother now.
Yes.
Ask and tell me. Actually, soaked the seeds. After that, night time they are grinding it. After that, early morning hours they are prepared to that. Okay, idli or dosa. Yes or no? This is the preparation. Yes. In that, glucose is converted into that, okay, that so actually here the process of the conversion of the sugar into the alcohol is called fermentation. The process of the conversion of sugar into the alcohol is called fermentation. Okay, so in that actually now you can see that so puri, preparation of the puri, that bubbles, that duff will come because of the production of the carbon dioxide gas. That is also, okay, so fermentation process. So here my point is, okay, here also already is there, microorganism use, commercial use of the microorganism. Microorganisms are used for the large scale production of the alcohol, wine, acetic acid or vinegar. So in this especially what we are using, we can use it to the yeast. What is that? Yeast. Yeast nothing but, okay, yeast is nothing but fungi. Yeast is nothing but fungi. Especially these are the alcohol and wine industry, generally we are used to the large scale. For this purpose we can grow in the natural sugars, especially in the like barley, wheat, rice, crushed fruit juice, we are production of the alcohol. So that is the use of the commercial use of the microorganisms. Are you understand? Next, next one, here, what is the meaning of the fermentation? The process of the conversion of the sugar into the alcohol is known as the fermentation. Fermentation was discovered by the Louis Pasteur, discovered to the fermentation in 1857. Okay, so this is about the fermentation. Next one is the use of the microorganism, medicinal use of the microorganism. Do you know antibiotics?
Yes, sir.
So these are the antibiotics we are making from where? Bacteria, fungus like. So actually you know very well, okay, when we are getting to the disease, when you are getting to the disease, that disease causing organism kill to that so that is disease causing organism enter in our body, kill to that our immunity power is decreasing. That time they are causing to that diseases, that time so in our body they are fighting, white blood cells are, they are fighting to again each other. That time white blood cells number is very less, we are suffering from the disease. White blood cells are more, we are free from the diseases. So that's why not sufficient amount of the white blood cells we are taking to the antibiotics. Okay, you know very well. Okay, streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin and penicillin, these are the antibiotics. These are the antibiotics we are getting from that microorganism. You can note down. What is streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin, penicillin? Note down. These are the antibiotics we are using to the from the microorganisms like bacteria and fungi. Now you can see, okay, whenever you fall ill, the doctor may give you some antibiotic tablet or capsule, okay, or injection such as a penicillin. The source of these medicines is microorganism. These medicines kill or stop the growth of the disease causing microorganism. Such medicines are called antibiotics. Such medicines are called antibiotics. So these days number of the antibiotics are being produced from the bacteria and fungi. Actually these are the antibiotics we are getting from the bacteria and fungi. Penicillin is the example of we are getting from the fungi. And streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin is we are getting from the bacteria. Getting from the bacteria. Okay. Next, do you know Alexander Fleming, do you know?
Yes.
Alexander Fleming discovered what? Penicillin was discovered by the Alexander Fleming. Penicillin was discovered by the Alexander Fleming in the 1929. Alexander Fleming is working on the culture of the disease-causing bacteria. Suddenly he found the spores of a little green mold in one of his culture plate. He observed that the presence of mold prevented the growth of the bacteria. In fact, it also killed many of these bacteria. From this, the mold penicillin was prepared. You are keeping your mind, Alexander Fleming was discovered to the penicillin. What you write? Alexander Fleming was discovered the penicillin. Next one, commonly known the antibiotics which are made from the fungi and bacteria. The antibiotics are manufactured by growing specific microorganisms and are used to cure variety diseases. You know very well, antibiotics are even mixed with the feed of livestock and poultry to check the microbial infection in the animal. They are also used to control many plant diseases. Now we can discuss about the vaccines. Do you know vaccines?
Vaccines, sir.
Do you know vaccines? So actually here, when a disease-carrying microbes enter our body, the body produces to the antibodies to fight that microorganism. The body also remember how to fight the microbe if enter again. If the dead or weakened microbes are introduced into healthy body, the body fight and kill the invading bacteria by producing suitable antibodies. Actually, you know very well, in our immunity system, okay, in our red blood cells, antigens and antibodies are present. Microorganisms are when they are entered, our immunity system is recognized. Some of the new foreign organisms are coming, they can increase their number. Okay, they can increase our immunity system. They are produced to the antibodies. If the antibodies number is more than the antigens, we are free from the disease. Otherwise, antigens number is more, antibodies number is very less, we are suffering from the disease. We are suffering from the disease. So that's why we are prevented to the diseases we are using to the antibiotics and vaccines. Okay. For example, cholera disease. Okay, polio disease. Polio vaccine only we can take. Diphtheria, you can take the diphtheria vaccine. Diphtheria vaccine is not working on the pertussis. Pertussis vaccine is not working on the, okay, polio. So each and every vaccine working on the particular disease only, not to the others. Okay, we will discuss vaccines. Vaccines first time discovered by the Edward Jenner. Okay, so for the smallpox in that 1798. Okay, this is we will discuss next class. Now you have the any doubts, please you can ask to me. Microorganisms lesson. Any biology doubts? Any doubts? No doubts?
No doubts means you are not concentrate on the studies. If you have concentrate, automatically you have the doubts. Okay. Please tell me. Any doubts? Regarding your school doubts also, please, you can ask, no issue. You are the state syllabus or CBSE curriculum?
State syllabus, sir.
State syllabus. First lesson is what? What is a science?
What is science,
sir? Second lesson is a what? Microorganisms.
The cell is the basic unit of the life.
Okay. So whatever it may be, that CBSE syllabus and state syllabus, we can merge and we will go to that one track.
Okay.
The fundamental unit of the life, you have the any doubts regarding?
No, it's
clear. Who discovered the cell?
Robert Hooke.
Who discovered the nucleus?
Robert Brown.
So who discovered that cell theory?
Cell theory.
Matthias Jacob and Theodore Swan. Cell theory discovered by the Matthias Jacob, Sladen and Theodore Swan. Okay.
Okay.
Next, what is the characteristic features of the plant cell?
Plant cell. How?
Cell wall is present. Vacuoles are present. Plastids are present. These are the characteristic features of the plant cell. You please read the test book carefully and ask to the doubt. Next time you are coming to the class, you are ready to come ask to the questions. Okay. If you are ready to ask, means you are learning something. If you are not asking, you are not learning anything. Are you clear? Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.